everybody. I'm Mark Chaffardini with Ghosty Talk. We're here at Fantastic Fest, the 10th annual Fantastic Fest, and we just got done seeing VHS Viral. And we're here with the stars and directors of the Bonestorm segment. Guys, why don't you introduce yourselves? And
Hey, my name is Shane Brady.
I'm Chase Newton.
I'm Nate Blanco.
I'm Aaron Moorhead.
Justin Benson.
Guys, Bonestorm are the nuts. Where did that idea come from, and when did you get involved?
I don't remember where ideas come from anymore, because Aaron and I don't just get like hired for stuff. We basically have to like beat down doors and throw six concepts at them. So I don't know. But skateboarding video is like one of the few ways into a found footage movie where you're motivating the camera that we just haven't seen before.
Mm-hmm. I know we pitched like a ton of ideas and that ended up kind of getting tossed out for one reason or another. Not even because they're bad, just like, oh, it's too similar to this other thing, or mm-hmm. oh, someone pitched us that and we can't do something that similar because then they're gonna think we ripped them off. We did like but they were all like high octane things. Like we had a demonic cop chasing another cop. We had a surfing segment. We had a skydiving battle in the air. And this is the one that ended up just really, really, really resonating. So. Mm-hmm.
What was it based on? You know, was it set in Tijuana, and it seemed to have some sort of weird Day of the Dead and religious undertones. Was it based on anything like that, or is this all made up mythology?
The mythology was entirely invented.
Okay.
And we basically wanted it to be as though when they're first there, it's like, oh, this is like a Santa Muerte thing, which is sort of in pop culture now. You see it in Breaking Bad, used to kind of build tone and make things dark. But that ultimately, it would seem as though, you know, these guys have like swords, and our own mythology that we just discussed personally was that centuries ago, conquistadors from Spain came over and they were into this like old world occult esoteric hermeticism stuff, mm-hmm. and that sort of combined with the local kind of voodoo-esque culture.
Gotcha.
And that's how it would start to feel after a while. This thing is just like totally invented and really old.
Okay. It was creepy as fuck, I really have to say.
Awesome.
So Nick, Chase, and Shane, when did you guys get involved? What were some of the first conversations you had with Justin and Aaron?
I actually got a phone call from one of my friends that they know from Florida, and that's how I got into this, just from skating, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I was actually supposed to go to a wedding, but I got a call saying that they were doing like a casting in East LA, and I ended up just not going to the wedding and going to the park and chasing it, and it ended up working out.
Oh, well, yeah, I got a call from the local skate shop owner, and they're looking for kid to skateboard movie, and I was like, all right, so I went in to try it out, and I guess they liked me from the start, so.
We didn't know the skate shop sent them down, and we like just like awkwardly walked up to them in a skate park in East LA, and like, hey, we're making a movie.
yeah.
Very questionable approach.
As soon as he like arrived, just because there's a particular character that plays Jason, of course, you know. And you know, he was written exactly as you see him in the film, and as soon as he arrived, he just slammed down his board and just had like a little cooler and a black flag shirt. It was like him.
On this podcast, then cool. How about you, Jason?
I was hired off Craigslist.
Yeah.
I run a business.
Was it for a role or was it just for the men for men?
I think it was just the men for men thing, but then like it's just. Through happenstance, just like these two guys, I'm just like at their house for the Men for Men Craigslist thing, and then they go, do you want to be in this movie for free? Actually pay us money. And I said, that sounds like a great idea. I've never done that before.
He's like, do I get copy credit meal? I'm like, no, man, NSA.
Just wanted that copy credit meal, yo.
I love the idea of a completely oblivious guy being like, well, I'm a man and I need to hire a man for this role.
Like, he has no idea. It's like, yeah, it's always awkward. These auditions are so weird.
It's not a misconnection.
Yeah.
It's pretty casual.
Yeah,
nothing can go wrong. Now, the stunts were incredible. I mean, you guys are doing your own skating and you're beating up, you know, those skeletons and, well, I don't even know what you call monsters, zombies. Like, what was that like, shooting, you know, being able to skate and then just beat the crap out of stunt people?
Man, at first it was kind of awkward, but then I was like, damn, this is pretty cool. Yeah, I've never done any work like this before, so, yeah, it was tight. I liked it. It was fun as hell.
It was pretty different. I don't know, like, when we go skate, you know, we go skate, like, before sunset and stuff, like, 6 p.m., and it'd be there, like, 7 in the morning, and hop in and start, like, skating a stitch. I was like, pretty crazy, you know, but ended up working out. The choreographing for like the fighting was way harder than I thought it was gonna be.
Yeah,
for real.
It was like a lot of work, you know. I didn't really expect it, but
tell
me
a little bit about Vince. Oh, so
oh.
There's this thing that like, it's funny because like if you saw it in real life, this is the one where you came down the ditch, went up, there's that bank that was like that,
yeah.
And you hit like a 5 foot
yeah
air, came so down,
right.
Landed it. Came down, grabbed a sword, and
yeah.
Took someone out. And he did it perfect like 6 times in a row.
Yes.
And when you saw
out,
it
yeah.
in real life, you're just like, this is so rad. And then when you see it on,
yeah.
on a POV camera, you're like, this doesn't do anything.
It's like,
that was another thing, like doing all that stuff, like swinging those swords, like we had no idea what it was going to look like, you know, like
mm-hmm.
seeing it a year later, actually like in effects and stuff was crazy.
Yeah, it was trippy.
Yeah.
Oh
my god,
it
was a year ago.
Yeah.
I know.
Oh,
wow.
Oh my god.
So, Bonestorm is one of the three segments plus the overarching vicious circles that kind of ties everything together. So. If you guys had been working on this a year ago, how long was this third part of the trilogy in development?
We got the call that we had it. We've been pitching basically since even the previous October. We first pitched it when we just saw Brad Miska walking by us at Screamfest. We're like, hey, you know, he's like, hey, do you guys kind of want to do a VHS? We're like, yeah, yeah, we'll talk. And he's like, all right. Like, and that was, so Screamfest, which was October of 2013. Was when it began, and then we got the call in late June of 2012. Oh my god, 2012, October 2012. Yeah, late June of 2013 was when we got the call, and it's like, all right, we're doing it, and we shot in September. Nope, August. Beginning
yeah.
of August.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, since it is kind of like found footage, a lot of it seems like it's, you know, made up and sort of happening at real time. How much of it was scripted? Because you talked about the choreography and stuff. I mean, did you let some scenes just go, you know, for
yeah.
the hell of it? Or?
Yeah, I think this is one of... Our next feature has like one scene that's improvised. This has more improvisation than anything we've ever done. Because what we found was that just letting these two dudes talk was like...
That's more interesting than anything.
Like you couldn't even. No one could write that. Like, and it was. Sometimes we would just put a camera on them, and we'd go off in units and just grab a video camera and just let them sit and be like, hey, talk about the last time you got in a fight. And like, you get them going about like their last fights, and then 10 minutes goes by and you've got gold. They forgot the cameras and you yell cut. They're like, what? They talk about the camera was there. And there's probably some legal issues.
So in terms of being part of a bigger film, obviously there's time constraints. So what kind of challenges did you run into bringing that to a cohesive middle?
I wish I could say there were a lot of challenges, but honestly, just when you write a script that's roughly 15 to 20 pages, it ends up there. And you always worry about being too short, too long, you know, and especially when you have an action scene, you don't want it to drag.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that I guess is... Pacing is always the big question, but mostly that's in the edit and a lot less in like production.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you find it. You just kind of it's not really a challenge as much as like it's kind of an instinct. After a while, you just watch it and then you eventually find it. Like, all right, this feels right. Yeah.
Okay.
Now there is a bit of a challenge in that VHS has kind of this like a mandate to go, you know, but you want to make sure that you actually like, really care about the characters as much as you can. And a lot of time, character building and fighting for your life are not the same thing. You know? So them chilling out in the parks, you know, sharing a joint, that's like, okay, I like these guys. They have like a deep history, that kind of stuff. So we did have to like spend some time where the camera doesn't really move and they don't move and all we're really doing is getting to know them. And that's always a bit of a dare in something that's as insane as VHS 3.
Mm-hmm. It's Brad Miska's concept, correct? He came up with the anthology concept for the VHS.
Mm-hmm.
How involved was he? And because we just got done seeing the ABCs of Death, and they were saying that all the directors never coordinated or knew what anyone else was working on. Did you know what other people were, like Nacho and Greg, you know what they were working on?
Only to the extent that if we were kind of given a note that like, oh, that's similar to the other, they would just make sure that we weren't being repetitive and there was nothing. But otherwise, we just didn't really know that much about the people's segments.
Okay.
I kind of like it that way.
Fun.
But
frankly, last night was the first time I'd seen the movie.
Oh,
yeah.
Get out of here.
I haven't seen Greg's segment at all till yesterday.
Okay.
Which is awesome. So.
Yeah.
Well, each of them were really over the top. So, you know, you were popping off the caps and you were shooting, shooting Roman candles. And
your arm ripped off.
Yeah,
my arm ripped off.
So, was there a level where you guys go, either this is not violent enough or, well, maybe we just don't need to go this far?
You know what's crazy is that, actually I never thought about it this way, is that the violence in the script, and it's always this way, is like exactly as it is on the page. Because it takes so much planning to do all those gags.
Yeah.
And when you're writing it, you're trying to escalate the violence, you know, push it further and further and further. You know, you're trying to go from arm ripped off to dude with arm ripped off, catching on fire, running into and guy decapitate. Like, you're trying to escalate all this violence so it has that visceral psychological impact. And it just ends up being like, oh, that was exactly what was on the page.
Mm-hmm.
Or pistol whipping someone and the gun gets stuck in their skull.
There was one moment on set when I was, when I'm lying down playing dead, and Nick has one of the skull face characters over his body, and it just, a literal pool of blood is just going all over him, right? But, the way that was presented, or at least the way I heard it was, you're gonna get a little blood on your face.
Me too.
This guy's gonna be, it's just gonna be cause Chase had some blood earlier and it was literally a speck here from when he bludgeoned the skull with this gun. So I had the luxury of being 3 feet away from Nick and I had my left eye open because I wanted to see what was happening. And the skull goes over him and take three of these pictures and fill them with blood.
It was like syrup and I didn't really, I thought it was going to be a little bit, you know, and it's just sitting there pouring on me. I'm like,
that was
one take. I didn't have to do that more than once. So
A lot of the kills were really improv. They looked improv. You're picking up bones and you're picking up, you know, bicycle handles and stuff like that. And there's so many kills out there, but do you guys have a one that you lean more towards? A favorite one?
Oh, man.
I feel like you gotta have one. The whole movie stops and just watches you kill a guy for 3 minutes.
Yeah, man. Just hitting dudes with a skateboard, man. You know, that's one of the best movies.
I still when I watch that sequence of the head getting bashed in, even though we made it, I'm still thinking the filmmakers are gonna. Nope, still not cutting. And still going in the heads, just getting smaller and smaller. And then but I feel like the one the set went crazy for was 13 motherfuckers. The guy's head.
He came
up that day on set. Everyone was just standing there, trying not to laugh. When we yelled cut, everyone was busted.
But you guys let the camera keep going.
Yeah.
Because it was just supposed to be 13 motherfucker, right? So he throws the head, and then it slowly rolls back down, and everyone's quiet, and then Chase, I don't even know if it was in character or just you, he just turns in and goes, "Hey, you good?" Killed a lot of fools, man. Killed a lot of fools. And that was the most brilliant shit I'd ever. That's the coolest thing about these guys is they had never acted before, and so one of the most common things for amateur actors is you go, okay, so 13 motherfucker. So they would throw the head and they go, okay, cool, we're done, cut, and they self-edit and they self-cut. But these guys always were just in it to the point where it was so awesome. We're just like Justin was saying, it's like cut, wait, what? Oh shit!
I'm sorry. I thought it was really cut. Some fools.
Method right there.
Yeah.
Well, guys, they say that this is probably the end of the trilogy, but if it goes on, I mean, you guys really upped the ante, so it's a tremendous segment. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, man.
Appreciate
it,
brother. Thanks, man.
Hell yeah.